So in previous session we have did like different types of data type in Salesforce Apex and introduction
Yeah,
of the
that
Apex.
see. Oops, sorry. Just a second. I can see two screens.
Now can you see this developer console, right?
One second. Yeah, yes.
Okay, no problem. So here you can see, and also previous session we have did like different types of data type in Apex and introduction of Apex and how to work on the anonymous window and developer console. Okay, so this is these all about the introduction about Apex. So do you have any question query till now? So you can ask me, otherwise we can go with next level.
I don't have any questions.
Okay, fine. So today we will learn like variable declaration. Okay, data type you know very well, so it's time to know about the variable declaration. So how to declaration our variable in Apex, right? So here you can see variable is nothing but a name to be get allocate memory location to identify a value, right? So it's a provide a memory location and identify which type of value you want to store in particular places, right? Variable are used to store the value temporarily, so it says store the temporary value. Okay, and syntax is here, you can see this is the syntax, and this is square bracket, then you have to write your access mod specifier or modifier. We will talk about this access specifier and modifier in upcoming session. Then you have to declare your data type, right? We know very well about the data type, okay, because we already did this session like data types, right? Then you have to write your variable name, then equal to n value, right? For example, integer, customer code, and this semicolon. So this is integer is nothing but it's a data type, right? Customer code is nothing but it's a variable. Which type of variable? Customer code is there, like store the integer value because it's an integer, right? So customer code is an integer type of value, right? And note down here, like if the user did not assign any value, then Apex will store the default value as null by default. If you don't assign any value here, assign means equal to operator. Okay, if you want to assign some value in particular variable or data type. Okay, so just equal to if you don't assign any value, so Apex automatic recognize as a null value. Like for example, integer is a data type, product code is a variable. This variable can do anything, or you can write anything here. Okay, it's a not hardcore rule to every time you have to write like product code, product name, like that. So based on your requirement, you can change this. Okay, so like integer product code, string product name, string designation, string email ID, something like that, right? So this is the way. Okay, and also you can give like some boolean value as well. Okay, so how to work on that like integer, string, decimal, and data type? So let me explain with practical here. So here you can see this is my org. Under setup, you can see my developer console. Just click this developer console and you can see my developer console window. Okay, so now here you can see under the debug tab, you can see like open execute anonymous window. So just click this open execute anonymous window and you have to write your variable or data type here. So first of all, syntax is like access specifier. Access, like just give me a single quote here, and before that let me show you comments. Okay, comments. So how to do that, this comments. Okay, so in Apex we have two types of comments. First is single line comment, single line. So comment is nothing but if you want to ignore something, so you can use this comments, right? Comment. Then we have second, that is called multiple line and comments, right? So if you want to do like single line comments, so always use this syntax like this forward slash, double forward slash. And if you want to do some multiple line comments, so always use this forward slash, then star, and you have to write your code here, something like that, this one, and then you just close this star and this one. So this is multiple line. Here you can see.
Okay.
Is it clear for you?
Yes, it's clear.
And here you can see this is a single line. Like this is single line. Okay, this is one line. Here you can see. And here you can see multiple line. 8 and 9 number you can see multiple line. Right? Okay. So this is all about the comments. So just clear all the things here to here. And now we have to write our syntax first, and then we will move slowly into the depth. Like syntax is this square bracket, X is specifier. Okay, then you have to give your data type here. Okay, data type, and after data type you have to write your variable name here, like variables. So here you can see this all bracket means you have to write your data type as well, and here variable name, then this assignment operator, and some value, like value or not mandatory, this is optional. So this is the optional value, so you can give. So this is the syntax. So let me define this variable with some practical exam, like axis specifier, anything. In upcoming session we will learn axis specifier, so please forget this now, here this line, and directly use this data type variable equal to, and then assign the value, right? So let me use data type. So which type of data you want to store? Integer, string, boolean, or something like that? Which one? So I want to store integer, so you have to write like integer. Okay, which type of variable you want to deploy? So like integer, then you have to write like product, odd, okay, and then semicolon. So you can match these all things with the help of this syntax. So here you can see like data type, right? So this data type is matched for this one, you can see, right? And
okay,
then this is variable. So variable is nothing but this one, you can see this variable, right? And yes, value. So I don't assign any value right now, and not equal to operator. So if you want to assign, so you can assign like that, product code equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, something like that, then semicolon. And you can comparison each and every syntax here, like data type. So this is the data type, right? Variable, which variable? This one. This is the variable. After the data type, always define your variable. Please keep in your mind these things, right? Then equal to, you can see this equal to here. This is the same for all, this equal to, right? And value, this is the value, you can see, right?
Yes.
So this is a syntax, and also one example like integer. Okay, so if you don't assign any value in any variable, or we can say that any variable, right, in Apex, so Apex automatic recognize as a null. So how to print that? How to print this product code?
Yeah, system.debug.
Yeah, great. System.debug. Use this system.debug, and then you have to define your variable, this one, right? This is the variable, this one, right?
Yes.
And paste it here, and just semicolon, and click this open log and execute. Okay, after that you can see there are so many logs is there in debug this context only. Just always use this debug only if you want to see your debug logs, so you can see your particular logs. So here you can see like null, right? You can see null value, right? So if you don't assign anything in Apex, so Apex automatic recognize as a null value in every data type or variables, right? Suppose I want to define some string, like string name, and semicolon, and I want to print this name as well. So how to do that? Just copy this line and paste it here. Instead of product name, you have to define like name, right? And then execute. Okay, and after that you can see both two null values. Here you can see first is come product name, product number, and second is like name, right? Both are null because of we didn't assign anything. Assign means we cannot provide anything value right now. Okay, so if you want to assign some value, so always use like if you want to assign new value, so always use like copy this product code here and just a second, just copy this product code and paste it here and assign some value like 1 2 3 4 5, something like that. Okay, you can assign name as well, like name in new line equal to something like Rohit, right? And how to print that? So just copy this one and paste it here, right? And give some big window so you can easily understand here, or just here, right? So this is our code to print the default value in Apex and to print some assignment value, right? So any reason here I didn't assign any data type before this product code and name? Any reason? Arsana?
Hello. Hello.
Yes, yes, tell me.
Yeah, I am having one doubt. Here, integer product code, there itself we can give the value, right? Product code is equals to 1 2 3 4. No need to write again separately product code in separate line.
Here, let's see. If you want to assign some, yeah, for your better understandable purpose, so let me, so I just assign this value in separate line. You can assign in the same line as well. No worry about that, like 1 2 3 4 5, something like that. Okay, so your better understanding purpose, that's why I am assigning here, right?
Yes.
So my question is before product code or name, I didn't assign any data type here. Any reason?
It shows an error.
No, not so the error. So please keep in your mind, if you already assign some data type like product integer, product code, string name, so no need worry about every time you have to define your data type, right? Because we already defined this integer and string for this variable, right?
No, I'm not getting it.
I am asking this one, like integer product code and string name, these all two variables like name and product code with this data type, right?
Then
my question is, why we need to define here like 7 and 8 line like product code and name? Why we did not assign anything like integer again here, like integer product code, string name here in line number 7 8? Why?
Yeah, here you can see we have declared there in first and second line already we have declared the data, right?
Yeah, exactly. So if you define already like some data type with some variable name, so no need to worry about every time you have to define your data type, right? So it's a global purpose.
Yes.
So define only one time and use anywhere. Okay, like that.
Okay.
So if you don't define this integer here, so it's throwing me error like that. So it's not recognize me because which type of data type is have right now? Okay, so this is the error. So always keep in your mind these things, right? Now you can see the output, two null, and in two, you can see the value as I assigned. Here you can see two nulls, right? And two values here you can see 1 2 3 and Rohit, right?
Yeah.
Because of this one. In first four or five line, we have nulls because we didn't assign anything here. And line number 7, 8, you can see I assigned some value. That's why I'm printing this value. Did you get these things?
Yes.
Okay. Any question, query till now?
No.
Okay. So we can assign this variable in the same line as well. So no need to worry about define another line, right? Like, let me remove this one and just remove these two lines as well, or just comment out. Better things is always use comment in your code, okay, instead of removing the code like that. Okay, so this is a single line comments, one by one line, you can see this, right? And you can define your like product code in a same line, like equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and name equal to some name like Apex, right? You have to see this value under this debug log. After that, you can see the value. Okay, so just click this debug only and you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and Apex. Okay, is it clear for you?
Yes.
Okay, so there are two ways to define the like variables and its value. So always keep in your mind. Suppose let's say, let me open my notepad and I will show you like that here. So if you like, we have two things. Keep this is the very most important, and please keep in your mind, like declaration and initialization. Okay. Initialization. I will show you this one here. First is declaration. So what is declaration? So like declaration. So for example purpose, like let's say example is integer. Okay, integer is. So this is the declaration. Here you can see. Okay, what is initialization? Second is initialization. Initialization is, this is the declaration and this is the initialization, like is equal to 1, 2, 3 or 3, 4, something like that. Okay. And also this line of code, we can initialize and declare in the same line as well, like declaration and initialization with in same line. So how to do that? Like integer.
Integer age is equals to 34.
Right. So here you can see within the same line, you can declare as well and you can initialize the value as well. Right. Is it clear for you?
Yes.
So there are two ways. So please, here you can see like declaration and initialization. So declaration is nothing but you can declare your variable with data type without any value. And initialization means, here you can see, you can initialize your variable with equal to operator and some value. Also reduce this line of code in same line. You can do these things with the same line, like declaration and initialization in same line, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So your doubt is clear now?
Yes.
Okay, fine. So let me move to the next slide. Like here, is it clear to you all, always? Here you can see integer and all the things, right?
Yes.
So you can define based on your requirement, like integer, string, decimal, date, and boolean as well. Okay, so this is the data type all, and after the data type, you have to define your variable. So in all value, you can see null value because you cannot see any assignment operator after this variable in each and every term. Okay, so all variable and all the things here as a null. Okay, right?
Yeah, okay.
Let me move next things. Variable declaration. We can define the multiple variable in a single statement. Here you can see. Like integer type, we have lots of variable with same data type. So how to declare in a same line? So like data type, then project code and team size. So with the help of comma separate, we can define multiple variable with the same line. Suppose we have same line, same thing value. So you can define same thing value in a same variable or same data type in a same line. So how to do that? So let me show you this one. So here you can see this is the developer console. And here you can see like integer, right? Age, or we can say that product code, because these all same kind of value is stored. Okay, like product code, right? So what is you can easily understand product code and age is an integer value, right? You can see. So we can define multiple variable in a same line with same data type. Like you cannot assign any Boolean value like is bool, something like here, because it's a Boolean and it's an integer. So you cannot store these two variable in a same data type. Okay, so this is a separate data type. So don't use this one, right? So always use same thing, same variable with same data type. Like I want to store multiple integer in a same line. So how to store? So just you have to write integer as product code. Like product code. Or if you want to define some prices, so you can define like prices, because price is integer value, right? Here with comma separate. So you can define multiple variable with same data type in a same line, right? Is it clear for you? Prasanna?
Hello. Yes.
Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, fine. Okay. So now you can assign and you can declare your variable in a same line as well, right? So don't worry about that. This is the separate things and this is the separate thing. So this is the reduce the number of line code. Okay, you can define these all things in a separate line as well. Don't worry about that. Like integer is already defined. So like product code semicolon integer price. You can see this is the best way, or this is the best way. Like this one, let me define age as well. Integer. So which one is the best? First one or second one?
First one is the best.
Yep.
But one thing in that line only, in single line only, we can assign even the values too.
Yeah, you can assign. Like let me show you with the value. So don't worry about that. So always keep in your mind, we can assign or we can declare the variable with the same data type in a same line, right? Also you can define like that, because it's a bad practice, because of it's having number of lines, like 4, 5, 6, three lines. It's having three lines. Number of space is it is taking now, right? But here you can see only one line, you can do everything, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So let me initialize this variable in a same line. So how to do that? Just remove this one. And age 20, and then 20 is equal to 20, then semicolon, and just use product code 101. Okay, then price equal to 100, something like that, right?
Yeah, comma, that comma should be taken, right?
Yeah, so let me check this one. So let system.debug and check this age first. So it's showing me error, because if you want to initialize your variable, so always remove this comma. Okay, if you don't want to initialize any variable, so without semicolon you can assign colon like comma. But here now you can see the output, the variable product code. So where product code? Here. So okay, so you cannot assign like a variable in a same line because of this is the apex. Some drawback is there. We cannot assign multiple variable in a same line. If you assign, like, let me check this is working or not. Okay, so this one or this one. Now it's working now, because that is the bad syntax for me, right? So you can assign this one as well. Here you can see this one. This is the good syntax.
Okay.
Okay, and also you can see the output. My output here, like debug only, and now you can see my age, like 20. So this is the way to assign initialize.
In system.debug only, can you like age, comma, product, code, comma, price, at a time?
No. So if you want to assign, print all the values, so always use concatenate, like plus operator. This plus operator, then give the one space, and always use. I will show you concatenation, so don't worry about that. This one, sorry, paste this one, and then again you have to write plus and just use price like that. Plus means concatenation. And if you want to execute this one, so you can see the output and all the values in the same line. Here you can see. So it's a concatenation, you can see. Let me show you.
2, 2, 1.
Yeah, it's a concatenation means addition. So it's add, like 100, 101 is 201, and 20 means 221, right? So it's a concatenation. So how to avoid this one? So it's add all the things.
So if you want to see, I'm saying one just a second. So if you want to see all this, I mean, it's like age 20, product code 101, and price 100. If all this should be displayed, means it should be like system.debug age and system.debug product code and system.debug price in single line, you should be you should write it.
You can write this one, but this is the not good way. If you write multiple line in a multiple things, so it's not good way. So always use this concatenation with this bracket, this one. This bracket, and if you want to print
I need the output output like age is 20, product code 101, price 100. It should not be calculated.
Yeah. So if you want to print like age equal to 20, product code 101, price equal to 100. So I will show you this one. So first of all, let me show you this one, and after that you can see my output as we expect. Here you can see 20. 101 100,
okay.
Right? But let always use this plus and this single quote in between the plus. And I want to show this meaningful, like this is the not good way to print all the debugs and meaningful name. So user friendly, if you want to print this user friendly, so like age equal to plus age, right? And then give some space plus. Okay, then you have to write your string like product code, then plus like product code. Just copy this one here, then give this plus, then one space plus which string you want, like price. Okay, price. Then you have to write plus and then use this price here. Price, and then print this one, so you can easily understand the meaningful name of this category. Here you can see after some time, here debug only, and you can see like A is equal to 20, product code 101, price 100. Also you can use like equal to here, like equal to, price equal to, and execute now, and you can see as you want the output. Here you can see. So Prasanna, you can check this one.
Okay.
Right? Is it clear for you?
Yes.
So you can print like that. So I will come that part. So don't worry about that. So first of all, we have to learn basic. Okay. If you have some basic knowledge and if you are strong in basic, so you can move to the advanced. Because it's some advanced version here. You can see here, let me open this one. So this is concatenation and some space is there. Okay, so you can use in upcoming session these all things. Okay, fine.
Okay, fine.
Okay, so here you can see, like we can declare multiple variable in a same line, right? You are clear in this thing, I hope. Right?
Yes.
Okay. And please do the practice as you can, as okay.
Okay.
So here you can see variable declaration, and now it's time to move next example. Also, you can see this example as well, like variable name equal to value, assignment value, how to assign the value. So project code, this one, team size 100, product title, this one, and all the things. So with the help of these things, we can apply, right? So in these things, what is data type and what is variable? Can you explain me? Integer, project code, in this area or in this context, what is data type and what is variable, like this one? Here you can see like
the integer. Data type is integer.
Yeah, right. And age?
What is it? Variable.
Okay. What is the use of variable?
Where we, I mean, it declares.
Okay, no problem. So it's the hold the value.
Like memory locations. Okay.
Yeah, memory location. So it's a hold the value. So let me explain this term and this line very deeply. Like here you can see. Suppose that in computer memory, you can see this is the one memory space, right? For example purpose. Under this computer memory, we have some location. So which type of location? So first of all, here you can see this is the integer location, right? Okay. This is an integer location. Integer, okay, or we can say that let me show you this one here, and let me write some integer, like in, or just let me show you another things better understandable. You can easily understand this one, right? And here you can see, let me draw this one. This is the memory location in the computer memory. Like under this here, you can see this is the integer type. For example, like let me take this integer, right? This is an integer. Under this memory, one box is there, like age. Okay, what is this? Age. Like age. Under this age, we have some value. That is called some value, like 35 and 36 here. So this type of architecture, we can say that this type of diagram is automatically created under the computer memory. Here you can see. Okay, like that. Like this is the integer. Okay, under this integer, you can see this age. Under this age, you can see my value. Right? Is it clear for you?
Yes.
Yeah. So this is another way. Okay. So now come to the next part, like operators. So how to work on the operators? Okay, so let me show you one by one how many types of operator we have and all the things. Like operators is nothing but it's a symbol, symbolic representation. Okay, so give me 1 minute. Sorry. Okay.
Hello? Hello? Rohit, hello?
Hello, Prasanna, give me some of you.
Okay.
Okay, fine. Okay. Can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so here you can see different types of operators. So operator is nothing but like anything, like plus, minus, this is the arithmetical, some relational operator, comparison, or we can say the logical operator. There are so many operators in Apex. So here you can see operator is nothing but it's a symbol which perform the operation on the operands. Okay, so like let me show you first. Here you can see this expression. You can see like we can say that integer, for example, for integer a equal to b plus c, for example. Okay, so what is a? Can you explain me what is a here?
Variable.
Yep. So A is a variable and plus is nothing but it's an operator.
B plus C is a value.
Yeah. Okay. So plus is nothing but it's an operator. Okay. It's all like B and C is the operands. B and C is the operands. These all operands. And this is operators. And combine these all things that is called expression. Right? Is it clear for you?
Yes.
Okay, fine. So let me explain this one, like arithmetical operation. So today we will learn these all operation right now, like arithmetical operation. So tomorrow onwards we will learn lots of things slowly, slowly. So here you can see like arithmetical operator and mathematical operator. Okay.
When will start from that? Collections list set map, from when we are going to start?
So I will not start immediately collection because it's a very deep concept. Okay, so first of all you have to learn this small things, then we will move slowly, so we can start collection after 1 week.
After okay. 1 week,
please. Yeah, so please be patient. Okay, so don't do like hurry and worry every time. So always learn this step by step things. So if you know this very well, so you can move, otherwise you can learn from here. So it's up to you. Okay, I will explain, I will teach each and every term and everything. Okay, so it's not best practice to directly move into the collection without these all things. Okay, so collection is not a simple line of code, it's a very big, or we can say that it's a very most important concept in the Apex. I will teach you in later, so don't worry about that. Right?
Okay.
Yeah. So please be focused, first of all, basics. So in this week, maybe in this week, I will start like OOPS concept in upcoming days. so don't worry about it. I will finish this basic tomorrow or day after tomorrow. Okay, so don't worry about that.
Okay.
So please focus on this like arithmetical and all the things, all the operators. Okay, so here you can see like arithmetic and mathematical operators. So both are same. So we have four operators, like arithmetical operators, like plus, minus, like multiply and division. Okay, like I want to perform some operations, like some addition purpose things. So how to do that? Like I want to add two numbers. So first of all, we have to declare like integer a equal to 10, right? You know very well this expression and assignment value and variable, right? We already did these things. Integer b equal to 20. Okay, I want to perform additional operation. Okay, like integer c equal to a plus b. You know very well this expression. Okay, under this expression, like a and b, what the value is here? I want to ask you. In this line,
10 plus 20, 30.
30 is answer. Yeah. Okay, fine. So how to print that? You know very well, like system dot debug and now system print dot debug. Okay, and these all value is stored into the C. So C is the our result. So you can print C. So just click this execute. And after that, you can see here debug only. You can see 30. Once you click double click, you can see the output like 30, right? Is it clear for you?
Yes.
This is the arithmetical operation. So you can perform, like, let me show you first this comment here that is called plus operator. Right? Operator. And now second is minus operator. Operator. Okay, so how to work that? So just copy this one, this code, and paste it here, and just remove this plus to minus, or just change this value 20 to 10. Okay,
then the value will be 10.
Yep. So here and you can see
the duplicate field. Yes.
Because of we already defined integer a, integer b, integer c. So you already use this integer a, integer b and c earlier. Now you cannot assign this value again and again, right? That's why I am facing this problem. Okay, so how to avoid that? So always use, like, you can change your variable, because variable should be or must be unique, right?
Yeah, but and always use, we can put their comments, right?
Yeah, you can put the comments as you want, like this one, or you can use.
Yeah, if you put like the comment A1. And if you use the same variables, we get the output.
Yeah, this one. You can use like that, right?
Yes.
Also comment this one as well, right? So you can use variable like that. Because comments is nothing ignoring. So Apex doesn't know about this line because you skip this line. Okay. And now you can print this one, like execute. And after that you can see like debug only, and you can see it like 10, right?
Okay.
And this is the minus and operator.
And now for multiplication too.
Yeah, multiplication, this one. So you can apply multiple line comments, like we already know this one, like this forward slash star.
You can show me there,
sir. No
problem. In that, example only we can do it, no problem.
Oh, you can do remaining things?
Yes, I can do it.
Okay, no problem. Okay, fine. So let me remove this one and this one as well. Okay, so this is all about the plus operator, right? And
yeah.
Another operator is relational and comparison operator. Both are same. Relational and comparison. Like less than, this is the less than symbol. This is the less than or equal to, greater than equal to, double equal to, not equal to, and equals. Okay, so these all under the relational operator. Okay, so how to perform the this operation under our console here. Okay, like I have two number, like integer a equal to 10 and integer b equal to 20, something like that. Okay, I want to find biggest number in between two numbers. How to do that? So which one is greater than? Greater?
20.
So how to do these things, like 20 is greater in programming language? With the help of relational operator, right?
Yes.
So with the help of relational operator, we can do this work. Okay, like greater than and comparison each and every term. Okay, so how to do that? So you have to write like integer, the result, integer c equal to, like which one is greater than? So let me check, greater
B,
than.
B is greater okay. than A.
B is greater than A.
A.
Okay, so it's always written the true false value. So always return the true false value. So always change this data type as well, boolean. So we can store the boolean value like true false into the boolean data type, right? You know very well boolean. Okay, so here you can see b greater than a means true. So if true, so you can see our syntax is right and we can print c value as well, like c. So it's showing me true. So let me show you this one here, and here you can see like true value, right?
Yes.
You can see true. B is greater than A because 20 is greater than 10. So it's showing me true. So let me show you like less than. So you can change this less than here. And now it's time to showing me false. Let me show you this false number as well here. Now you can see like false, right?
Yes.
You can see false. So this is all about greater than and less than. So remaining operator we will learn tomorrow onwards, like greater than, less than, equal to, not equal to, and all the things. So please do practice and learn more. Okay. So we will meet soon. See ya. Bye bye. So any question, query till now, so you can ask me and you can leave your message in your Skype group. Okay, so thank you.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.